let's start with basic democracy lessons. So, what you think is irrelevant? What's relevant is only what I think. One of the things that annoys me on plasma files, there are lots of things that annoys me there, but on this particular video I will talk about the file name labels. And every time I refer that here, I get complaints, so it is time for some deeper investigation and show you exactly what I mean. For this demonstration I'm using GNOME files 337.1 from Fedora RPM, and plasma files from Flatpak, that I will politely skip to comment on how it looks, but it is version 1912.3. And I will start with GNOME and my whole life, officially released in 12 episodes. The first thing to note here is that I'm using the 100% icon size. If I zoom out everything will get unreadable, but Ubuntu considered that was the best default. So, what's happening here? Nautilus will trim file names to 3 lines, that most of the times is sufficient, but not on this case that the episode number isn't visible. Another thing is that Nautilus always trims the last part of the string. If we want to see the full file name, we need to select the file and then the full string will reveal. So now we can navigate with arrows to see the next or previous files. If we make a multiple selection, then we can also see the file name, but sometimes the text overlaps on the icons, especially when we select multiple lines. However, in real-world example that's rarely an annoying behavior. A last thing to highlight, is on the renaming we get this popover, that is convenient enough for long names. Not super, but almost okay. Next is Plasma's turn, and I will try with the same icon sizes, but I will skip discussing the grid system and make a super long video. Okay. Lots to cover here, so let's do this. So we again have 3 lines visible here, but we have 2 major differences. First of the trim is different, and on Dolphin it allows us to see the file extension which is a better behavior than Nautilus, I think. Second, the labels are more narrow so they can display less text, which is why you see a more compact files grid. And again, I'm not going to extend on grid by resizing the icons. I believe I have picked an optimal default size, or something close to optimal anyway. What really annoys me here, is that if we select a file we still can't see the full name. And a second please to show you one more thing. If we try to rename this file, we'll get that scrollable text box that is virtually impossible to edit. And basically I'm going to copy this to reuse it later. Now, the first we can do to see the full name is to open the sidebar previewer, and do arrows navigation. However in this specific case it is slow, because we lose focus from our files. And yep, Nautilus really needs a previewer. Anyway, let me close this, and go to our next option that things get interesting. From menu, and configure Dolphin, and view modes, we have an option to change the maximum lines, and I will set that to unlimited, and apply. What happens now, is that Dolphin will display the full file name no matter how long that is. In this case it will work super, but it is very obvious that isn't an option we can constantly change depending the context. Another thing is that Dolphin will now display 7 lines, when in Nautilus the same text was only getting 5 lines. So another choice is to change the label width from medium to large. And now we get this. 4 lines file name, and extremely wide. So the normal is too small, and the large too large. The story of KDE life, they just can't figure out the optimal. And now I'm explaining the file names for 10 hours, and I'm not even done yet. And if you start playing with grid sizes, you will spend 10 years to find the best. And to address GNOME users' considerations why files has virtually a single icon size, it is because GTK3 sucks. And not only it sucks, it is actually a dead project for almost 4 years and since they're moving to GTK4. And yet, that single size works better than the unlimited configurations of Dolphin. Let's go back to the video, and I will revert to medium to show you why the unlimited lines or even more than 3, is a terrible idea. So I will open a new tab on my home folder, and I will supersize a file name here with the text I copied before. And now Dolphin will leave all this empty space. Honestly? What the hell are those things? and even if we open the options and set label to large, which it is really large, we will again get the same issue more or less. And you know what's the most pathetic thing? That's perhaps the most usable configuration we can set. Oh, and because I'm pretty good on discovering tiny visual issues that nobody else mentions, look what happens when we rename this folder back to Fuchsia. This video is not to tell what file manager is better, but just demos a very certain functionality between the two. As someone that I have used a lot, and I'm still using both file managers, I'd say that GNOME files is better for the 70% of cases, and especially when I'm using my laptop on the floor, that I use lots of hours really. However, a benefit I must to give on Dolphin is that is faster when lots of files. But as I told you before, GTK3 kindly sucks, and must mean an agonizing death. By the way, I had opened that issue on video thumbnails that they were creating something like an eye illusion, and it was quite annoying to me at least. So that is fixed, and I don't know if you have the update already, but that's how the icons are now.